Hello everyone, my name is Yeagerbr and welcome back to the third and final video of this Steamboat Willie build. It's almost over now. Step 3 is the longest phase without a doubt. So I don't want to spend a lot of time introing this. So be excited, it looks super cool. As well as I really feel like I should need to try to see if this will float in the end. But on to the video. The third and final phase. All right. Let's see. So first, it wants us to put the mini together. I am not seeing mini. Oh, I see her head. Her head and her body. And her guitar. Minnie's classic guitar that everyone knows she has. Kind of needs some legs, though. Oh. She needs her skirt first. I don't want Mickey seeing her diaper. Also super curious about what's in this little box. We're gonna save that. Also a super interesting little skirt kind of piece. There. There. Now she's ready to play her guitar. As soon as we find her a hat. Because everyone in the 1920s wore a hat. Whoa. We'll find our hat when we find it. Okay. So we need one of these, like, what I would have thought was a steering wheel. Actually, we're gonna need to open all these things. I do see Minnie's hat. So that'll be nice for her to have. Maybe I don't dump these in the middle of the pile with the big pieces. Because they're all pretty small. A little hat with a little daisy on top. Keep opening. I'm waiting to throw a bag aside, and then hear the little plastic clicks of Legos coming from it. Alright, so we got one of these. To cover it with two of these. Oh, we're making the fairy wheels. So two of those. Another one of them. And just like little cap cover things. So this goes on the bottom. And this one goes on the top. Next part's pretty detailed. Not pretty detailed, but I need to do it 8 times. Alright,
So we start off with one of these. One of these. Another plane piece. Another hook. And a cover. Nope, that's not a cover. Oh wait, this one has the covers. And another mini hat. Well, I guess I can't expect her to have only one hat. Yeah, so I need to make 8 of these little things for each of these. And they'll just snap right onto there. So that's pretty neat. So let's line up 7 of these. Do this Henry Ford style. Right, 2 of them. 2 of them. Instead of sitting them down, I should just put them directly onto these. Three. Four, 5. All right, just last one for this wheel. All right, now I need 7 more of these hooks. Sheet music, so I know I don't need that. So in all of this that I opened in for phase 3, there's only one colored piece. It's this little red thing. So that's gonna be interesting to find out where that goes. I mean, I'm assuming it's gonna pretty much get hidden, but I have no idea. The annoying part for this, as soon as I finish this one, I'm guessing the next step's gonna be do it 8 more times. Unless it's gonna keep me on one side of the boat and then head back for the other side, but I can't imagine that. Alright. Our nice ferry wheel. Oh yeah, it does say to do this twice. Well, might as well go ahead and slap it on there. I think I heard some pieces dropping. I did. Hope it was just that one. Because otherwise, or maybe it would have been an extra piece. That would be swell. Frame of it. Now I just need all these little pieces. So the hooks. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 16 of these things. There's 2, 4. There's so many little pieces. Which I guess is alright, because it's a lot of fine, detailed work. Which is kind of the point of Legos, I think. Because if this was just a plain, one-piece solid toy, it wouldn't be nearly as enjoyable. As with this, I can set Mickey. I can set these in that picture frame I showed earlier, all in one little cluster together. Or nicely spread out around my office slash house. Alright, so let's see, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Shucks. 7, and one more. And one more. All these up. That's not the right piece. Onto here. Curious how many pieces this is, because it's 5 times 8, so that's 40. Plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. So between the two of these, that's like 92. Yeah, 92 pieces. Let's see, we just slap that on the other side. Now, yeah, so it spins, the steam clouds go up and down. All right. So I need some grays and some whites. Six, seven, eight, and a 10. A white one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's only 6. Where's the 8 one? This one. Alright, so nice little middle piece. Let's try to get this back where I can see it pretty well. Goes right up behind there. All right. So 4 of these little 1x1 tile gray pieces. Snap them together. For the 1x2 blocks. Okay, there's the last one. And 2
of the little pieces with the little fronts. One, two. Alright, so goes one, two, the little piece with the fronts. Goes right like that. These little pieces that I made. Two life preservers. They just hook right on the inside of here. I'll get you a nice. Here, I can go ahead and do it now. Just throw the preservers inside there. So I'm guessing this is going to be all open. Alright. So I need two bars of various lengths and two flat pieces. Now it looks like I'm making some weird contraption again. Move that mystery item to the side. So put those together. Get a little cross beam. Up. Then it gets stood up like this. Then it goes. So let me see. I need to put two of these little pieces to cover this back here. Now it goes on top of these smokestacks. Okay. Two of them. Guessing two of these different sizes again. I think I'm just mirroring what I did last time. I hope so. We'll just set the little birdie off to the side for now. You still see a little bit of green and yellow on the side. Same goes for this side. Not much in there, but I'm not sure how much more we'll cover up. Alright, so two of these, one of the willies. And two of the little like individual pieces. All right. Okay. So I see what it's showing. So right, first we're covering up this whole back piece. Just two little white squares for each of the ends. And a nice long piece. Cover up all that. And then the SS Willie. Which I'm pretty sure was not the name of the ship. Alright, and now back around to the front. We're gonna do about the same thing. Alright, so we got the Willie. Nice long pieces.
Another long piece for the front here. And now two little tabs. Okay. Tab here, and one of those on this side. Alright, and now, I don't know why, but I'm connecting two of these little 1x2 strips. Right, I'll just put them there, and there. Time for the steering wheel. I'm just gonna slap that right there. That made some good spins. I'm gonna try to get this bird back on here while I'm. Okay. Does the bird get a hat? I don't know. Because he has a little notch in his head, as if a hat would fit there. Alright, so now four of these little things. There we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, little bead, okay, thank you, I'm curious where it's going to make more, where I should be putting Steamboat Willie in the end of this, if he should be driving the boat, or if he should be enjoying it on the deck. In here. Don't know why. I guess I do still need to make like the crane. Is this a light? Not sure what that's supposed to be. But I do know it goes right here. Oh, maybe they're the bells. Some windows. Right, one of those. Those. Another window. And another one of these. Right, two little thin pieces. Up to you. Getting worried. Alright. Don't. No idea what. I think this might be for the crane. Oh, I know it's gonna be the roof. Duh. That makes a lot of sense. Okay. Five of these smooth pieces, or three of these smooth pieces in there. Most of this. Almost all out of the white pieces. Flip it over. Right. I had to flip it over a few times to figure out which way is the right way. Whoops, that's not the right piece. It'll go like here. There's a piece. Right. Square. Nope, not that kind of square. This kind of square. I was wondering why it was sitting on level upside down. Alright, three of these little black things. One more. Alright, now we just slap that in there. Alright. Nice. More of these steam pipes. I wonder if I'm gonna add, like, make them even higher. So we need to put five of these on. So one, two, three, four, and five. So that's one of those. We need to do a second one. One, two, three, four, and five. All right, so now we need a one part hook, two part curl. That into them. Add another piece. Let's see, I need that for the other one. Again, I apologize, doing this on a black piece on a black desk is... Yeah, you can barely see this piece that I was just working on. Like, whenever I look at it on my computer screen, it looks like it was all black and white. Alright. So now let's shove these down in them. Look in, but they're not. I hate how, like, these don't never seem to line up perfectly. Whoops. We'll fix that. That's not right at all. Yeah, that's not gonna fit. Alright, so that's four of them. Which. I feel like. Be able to hold this whole thing up, which is super hard to get a grip on. Alright, I'm thinking I can build this in reverse, and I might be able to do it. Now, I just need to get five of these down through here. Wait, which way do you go? So it has to go like this. Oh, that's the problem. Duh, they're round and I need to fit them in. See why it tells you to do it that way, because you don't have to worry about lining up everything. You don't have to worry about the rotating pieces lining up. Again. Way more than I wanted on that side. Okay. We'll come back around to that. We're gonna put more things on here that I could potentially mess up. That's weird. Piece that
I needed that I couldn't find rolled right to me. Little window things. We're gonna combine them. Into that. Let's see, it goes up at the front. You need to get back to your post. See a hook going up. This and the flag. Okay, well. Nice little flag there. Putting our supplies way back here. Let's see. So one goes there, one goes there. Okay, that's cute. These little, have like a little skillet, a little mug, and they just get hung up right above here. Because where better to keep your cooking utensils than outside your ship? So, we got a bin of potatoes, which they just go up here all cockeyed like. Alright. Get all these pieces back into the light. I need 4 of those. Black piece here. Hopefully you can see this much better against my white hand and against the black disc. Alright. So this goes in the very back as a rudder. Wait, that's the front. Yep, so we got a nice little rudder here. This, I better show it on this camera. All right. One of these pieces goes in here. This thing goes on facing up. It has the two facing up. I don't know if that matters, but I feel like it should. Sorry. Alright, so one of these going up out of it. Let's see, another rod. And a little grabber do on the end. And then a little red piece in here.
Wait, no, I didn't. I just can't look at a picture right. Alright, so I'm gonna put all of these together. On the other end, it gets this weird, funky piece. But it is. So it hooks on and can swing. Well, I think I figured out what's in the mystery box. And this is gonna get complicated, probably. String. Great. Some little more string to work with. All right. I did not realize knot tying was a necessity. I would need to have to do this. Definitely be secure. I'm glad that there's no way you can see how bad I am at tying knots on this. Glad that camera quality is not that fine. Doesn't help that the whole piece rotates. Now this piece can't rotate away from me. Let's see if we can, if I unwind this. Let's just. Hoping to get that initial loop unwound and buried. All right. Oh. I didn't even think you'd want to wind it a certain way so we could unwind a certain way. Which is funny because there's like two ways that it could go and I did it the wrong one. I'm very concerned because I know, because I have to tie this on to one end, I'm gonna have to tie it on to something else at the other end. Hand crank. That didn't sound good, but everything's still alive. Alright, I just have to hook it onto this hook. No, nothing too hard about that. Any tips on rope tying? Oh, that's cute. All right, there's one loop down. Two loops, because I hate this and I really never want to have to do it again. We're gonna put a third loop on just for, to make sure it's never, ever coming off. Ever. Probably, hopefully. Wheel this up in. Right, so I'll have to get scissors and cut that. I don't think I. This thing might work if I'm careful. That should be good. This thing, and I like what it's suggesting, is to hook your potato bender here. So now, like, you pick it up, swing it around. Oh yeah, I'd have to release it. Nope, that's the other way. Yeah. Maybe we won't play with this. Maybe this is a looky toy, not a play toy. Actually, I would like it out one click, just to give it some. Yeah. All right, now we got a bucket. I handle. Put them together. Click that right on the back there. We got this hammer. They just throw it back here. Hazardous work environment. Oh, I see it. No big grand ending picture. Okay. All right. So we need Mickey and Minnie in here. And I need to figure out these things. Didn't I break something else too? There's an extra. There's a wrench. I'll just toss that back on the back with the hammer. We have Minnie's music sheet. I literally have like no idea how to do this. Alright, we'll take the roof off of you. I didn't hear anything breaking, so I can assume everything is okay. Mickey, you get into work there. We can even angle you out a little like the picture shows you. Steering wheel's way too high for your face, but that's your problem. Minnie, you can be sitting back here. Throw your little notes thing there. Right, now I just have to get these smokestacks. All set. Okay. But I really have no idea what to do with these things. Because even though it looks like I was just making progress, I was just lifting these up. But I think that's a problem for me to figure out. Oh, here. Put this roof back on so Mickey doesn't get wet. Alright, and I think we've done it. Let me just put all that aside. Drop that book down, actually. Yeah, so if you're interested in this, it was Mickey Mouse Lego number 21317, Steamboat Willie. Yeah. It was super time consuming overall. I think it was like 2 hours, and I still have to try to figure out those things. But overall, let's see how she runs. It's like those steam clouds, like, don't have enough free space to fall back down. There it is, she's gone. We can even. Alright, I got this nice little Mickey plaque out of that. So, put that right on top. Right on front. Actually, yeah, that's. So you can see Mickey's in there steering the ship, obviously. I hope that was an extra piece because I don't know where it should have gone. If not, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this, me putting this Lego Steamboat Willie ship together. I enjoyed it and can't wait to display it. If you like, I'll be posting a short video Instagram. We'll see if this thing can float or not. It says it can't. What do you weigh? There's a couple pounds to you. That hammer and that wrench in the back not being secured is rolling around. But thank you so much for watching. If you like this, please like, comment, subscribe. As always, I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.